Terence Clark. I am from Memphis, Tennessee. My granddad was a pastor of his own church. So I grew up in that church playing. My dad, he was a music minister. At the age of 2 was when I got my first drum set. And so that was interesting. The story goes, like, my dad, when my mom was pregnant with me, she said I would rumble in her belly, and my dad used to play rudiments on her stomach. So that was interesting. So I came out naturally wanting to play beats. Gungor was a very God thing, not anything of myself. There was a friend of a friend, awesome guy named Calvin Noel. He's an artist and a manager, and Gungor needed a drummer. And at the time, I just got Gungor's record, and I was posting all these lyrics of the song because I was blown away. I was like, no one writes like this. I've never heard Christian music like expressed like this in a very vulnerable way. And they contacted me, and they were like, you know, Gungor needs a drummer. Can you do it? I was like, yes, I can do it. And so Michael and Lisa never heard me play. They never met me. We met in Nashville, and we just jumped in the minivan and drove from Nashville to Florida for the first gig. I was only going by, like, me listening to the record, like, straight through, and so just playing it that way. And obviously I did good, and they kept me around. My major musical influences are, and would have to be, starting with my grandfather. We called him the leader of the band. He sang and played guitar, and he just brought us all up, not just in like the Bible and godliness, but like music. And so he is number one because he taught us how to follow and flow. And then my dad, of course, taught me the skill side of it. One of my favorite drummer slash producers is Steve Jordan. He is amazing, and he is one of my major influences. Ray Charles, Tommy Sims, Steve Gadd, these are all like drummers and producers and songwriters. One of the things I've learned about touring, and I'm still learning a lot, but one of the things I've had to learn is the balance of like being home and that life and then the touring life. Being on the road is not as like glamorous as it may seem or sound. You're around a lot of people all the time, in close quarters on a tour bus. And thankfully, in my experiences, it's always been like great people. So the hang is important. You have to be around good people with no egos, and you have to check yourself. You know, you don't want to be in a place where you know, it's about you. You have to have a balance. And then remembering the purpose of why you're on the stage and just respecting everybody's time and showing excellence, not just in your skill, but in your character and having integrity. A lot of people forget that and get caught up in the celebrity. And that's not real at all. It really teaches you independence. Like at a church setting, most people get used to going to the church and listen to the pastor and they say this and it's like, yeah, okay. And you get built up every week. When you're on the road and touring, you forget which day it is. And so like, you're used to going to church on Sunday, you know, it's like, Sunday will pass and come and go. And it's like, oh, so you have to make time every day to get in the word, to humble yourself. It's very easy. A lot of people who travel, whether it's secular, Christian, whatever, it's easy to get jaded in what you do. But I believe for Christians and believers, it's easier for us to get caught up and forget what we're doing and the purpose. You have to remember, like, yes, we're doing the same thing every night, but it's different people out there. Someone out there is needing something. Someone's coming to be fed. And so we need to pour out and be ready to pour out. And if you're not pouring into yourself, or people pouring into you, you really have nothing to give.